again. Hello, hello again. Hello, hello again. Welcome back to music. Hello, hello again. Hello, hello again. Hello, hello again. Welcome back to music. Let's have some fun and we'll sing some songs. Music makes me so happy and free. Hello, hello again. Hello, hello again. Hello, hello again. Welcome back to music.
Hello, fifth grade. Welcome back to music class. Thanks for joining me on our third digital music class together. Hope you've all had a great week, and hope you're ready for some fun musical action. Let's take a look at what's in store for today. Starting off, as always, with our hello song and a quick warm-up. Today we're going to work on the groove of the week, and then we're going to work some more on Scarborough Fair. And then I'm going to ask you to think about a song you might want to share with us for this week as a little bit of an assignment. We'll do our last little bit of our Musician of the Month for the month of April, and then we'll sing goodbye. Now, my goals for today's class is perform the groove of the day, or I guess it's the groove of the week, since I won't see you for another week. We're going to add the second part to our song Scarborough Fair, the second verse. And then we're going to talk about thinking about a song to share with each other, a little project we're going to do there. But let's go back to me. And we'll warm it up a little bit. So last time we did a little warm-up where we kind of shook out our body one bit at a time. So we started with shaking out our hands and then shaking out our feet. And as we did it, we shook four times each hand. And it went like this. One, two, three, four. Other hand. Two, three, four. Shake your foot. Two, three, four. Other foot. Two, three, four. And we're going to do that, except we're going to go four times, three times, two times, one time, and eventually just shake your whole body out. All right, so let's try it. Get your hands ready to shake, and here we go. Oh, one, two, three, four. One, two, three, four. Shake your foot. Two, three, four. Other foot. Two. Now we do it. One, two, three. One, two, three. Shake your foot. Two, three. Foot. Two, three. One, two. One, two. One, two. One, two. One, 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 and shake it all out. Give your face a big shake like this. And why don't you shake your lips out like this? And maybe you can sing while you do it and it sounds like this. Try that again with me. Ready? And a nice big yawn. How about a bigger yawn? Okay. For today's little vocal warm-up, we're going to do Zynga Mama. And really listening for the letter Z and the letter G in here, and it sounds like this. Zynga Mama, Zynga Mama, Zynga Mama, Zynga Mama, Zing, Zing, Zing. Just like that. Let me grab my trusty melodica and go on for this. Zinga mama, zinga mama, zinga mama, zinga mama, zing, zing, zing. Just like that. Now, I'm really listening for at the beginning of the word, the z sound, a nice buzzy z sound. And at the end of the word, a nice g, zing, not zing. Try to make sure that the g is nice and pronounced. And it's zinga mama, zinga mama, zinga mama, zinga mama, zing, zing, zing. Let's try it. Zinga mama, zinga mama, zinga mama, zinga mama, zing, zing, zing. Zinga mama, zinga mama, zinga mama, zinga mama, zing, zing, zing. Zinga mama, zinga mama, zinga mama, zinga mama, zing, zing, zing. Zinga mama, zinga mama, zinga mama, zinga mama, zing, zing, zing. Zinga mama, zinga mama, zinga mama, zinga mama, zing, zing, zing. Zinga mama, zinga mama, zinga mama, zinga mama, zing, zing, zing. Zinga mama, zinga mama, zinga mama, zinga mama, zing, zing, zing. Nice job, nice job. Go ahead and take in a deep breath and sigh for me now. How about a bigger breath with a bigger sigh? Just let all your problems and worries melt away. All right, let's take a look at our groove of the day. Groove of the day. At the bottom of the screen here, you will see a 4-measure rhythm featuring some of the rhythms we've worked on this past year. And we're gonna go measure by measure to figure them out, and then we're gonna groove on them with some background music in just a little bit. So take a look at this first measure here. You'll notice it features one of our Tom T rhythms. Take a look at it, pause the video, and practice saying it and clapping it to yourself. Go ahead and pause. Nice job. Let's take a look at what this rhythm is. It's Tom T T T Ta. Say that with me. Ready? Go. Tom T T T Ta. Nice job. Take a look at measure number 2 now. Look at the rhythm, think it in your head, pause the video, and practice it. All right. Welcome back. So now take a look at the second rhythm, and up on the screen it is ti-ti-ta, ti-ti-ta. Say that with me, ready, go. Ti-ti-ta, ti-ti-ta. If we go back to the beginning and do the first and second measures, we have tom, ti-ti-ti-ta, ti-ti-ta, ti-ti-ta. I like it. Take a look at measure number 3. Now, I'm not going to ask you to pause the video for this one because right here, this should look familiar because it's the exact same as measure number 1. So this measure is also tom, ti-ti-ti-ta. Let's try the whole first 3 measures together. 1, 2, ready, go. Tom, ti-ti-ti-ta, ti-ti-ta, ti-ti-ta, tom, ti-ti-ti-ta. Then we've got one more rhythm to go. Take a quick look at it. Think it in your brain. Decide, what rhythm is that? Aha, there we go. Let's try it together. This one is cinco pa tu. Say that with me, already go. Cinco pa tu. So if we look at this whole 4-measure rhythm, and we say and clap the rhythm, it sounds like this. Start at the beginning. 1 and 2, and ready, go. Tom, ti-ti-ti-ta, ti-ti-ta, ti-ti-ta, tom, ti-ti-ti-ta, cinco, pa, tu. Nice job. Great rhythm reading, great clapping. So this is now a great chance for you to get one of those found sounds, some sort of instrument around your house that's maybe a musical instrument or maybe not. So let's see, my found sound for today is going to be my water bottle. Haha. It's not really an instrument, but if I take a pen and my metal water bottle, check it out. Ti-ti-ti-ta, ti-ti-ta, ti-ti-ta, tom, ti-ti-ti-ta, cinco pa tu. Now, the reason I call this the groove of the day is because I want to take this rhythm and I want to take my instrument, be it a water bottle, a can of oats, or just clapping using your own body. Or hey, if you've got a clarinet or a trumpet or a violin around the house, you could try playing it on there too. And I'm going to pull up some music from our musician of the month, The Roots. And we're going to use this as sort of our backing track for our groove. So here is some Roots. That's nice. And basically, you got your instrument ready. We're going to play the rhythm with the groove. A 1, 2. A 1, 2. Ready, go. Ta, ti, 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 ta, ti, ti, ta, ti, ti, ta, ta, ti, 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 ta, si, go. Do it again. Ta, ti, 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 ta, ti, ti, ta, ti, ti, ta, ta, ti, 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 ta, cinco, pa, two. One more time. Last time. Job. Nice job. See, these rhythms are always more fun when you've got an instrument and you've got a groove to go with. So thanks to The Roots for our groove for today. All right. Let's jump back here for a second. So, last time we started working on a song called Scarborough Fair, and it was sort of made famous by, it's an older folk song, but it was actually kind of, you know, made famous in the 60s by our friend Simon and Garfunkel. So let's revisit that for right now and check out Scarborough Fair by Simon and Garfunkel. Not bad, not bad at all. So the part that we sort of started working on last time was the beginning. And it goes like this. Are you going to Scarborough Fair? Parsley, sage, rosemary, and thyme. Can you try singing it with me this time? From the beginning. Ready, here we sing. Are you going to Scarborough Fair? Parsley, sage, rosemary, and thyme. Well, let's take a look at the second verse of this song today. Now, the story behind this song is that there's a man singing it, and he's sort of telling his friend to go visit this woman he once loved. And he's saying, hey, tell her to do all these impossible things. And if she can do all these impossible things, I'll take her back. And so, it's sort of this kind of beautiful, haunting song, but as you sort of listen to the words, it's kind of an interesting subject matter. So in this part of the song, this next verse, he's going to ask her, it's like, hey, I'll be your love again, but you need to make me a shirt without a seam. And a seam, you know, is like right here where they stitch the material together. It's kind of hard to do that. It's kind of almost impossible to make a shirt without a seam, so he's sort of enlisting this impossible task to this woman he once loved. All right, so the next part goes like this. Repeat after me. Tell her to make me a cambric shirt. Your turn. Tell her to make me a cambric shirt. This next part is the same. Parsley, sage, rosemary, and thyme. Parsley, sage, rosemary, and thyme. Next line sounds like this. Without a Classy or fine needlework. Ready? Without a seam or fine needlework, then she'll be a true love of mine. Your turn. Then she'll be a true love of mine. Nice job. This song kind of covers a large range of our voice. So right now I'm sort of singing down in my singing voice. But if you really want to be singing this song well, I want you to try singing it up in your higher singing voice. So let's do a little repeat after me in our higher singing voice. Forgive me if I sound a little squeaky. Tell her to make me a cambric shirt. Tell her to make me a cambric shirt. Parsley, sage, rosemary, and thyme. Parsley, sage, rosemary, and thyme. Without a seam or fine needlework. Without a seam or fine needlework. Then she'll be a true love of mine. Then she'll be a true love of mine. Now, I know it doesn't always sound great when I try to do it, but if I was in fifth grade, it would sound a little bit better. So as we're singing this song together, access your higher singing voice. Sing up in your head voice. Don't be singing down with me, because it won't necessarily be your best singing. Okay? Let's try this second verse together. Ready? To make me a cambric shirt. Parsley, sage, rosemary, and thyme. Without a seam or fine needlework. Then she'll be a true love of mine. And let's go back to the beginning. Are you going to Scarborough Fair? Parsley, sage, rosemary, and thyme. Remember me to one who lives there. She once was a true love of mine. Nice job. Really beautiful singing. Good work, good work, good work. All right. Enough of that song for today. The last thing that I'd like to sort of have you guys do for me today, and this is a little bit more of a project you can do on your own time, is I want you to be thinking about some music this week. And specifically, sort of be thinking about what sort of music, what sort of songs, and specific songs that you listen to that are sort of helpful during this time. You know, this time of being in our homes and not being able to go out and see each other can be very stressful. And music has this great way, this great power to sort of relieve some of that stress and kind of transport us away from our problems, if only for a short amount of time. So I want you to think about those songs that maybe help, make you happy, help put you in a good mood, help motivate you, help inspire you to be, a better person. And this music can come from anywhere. It can be music with words. It can be music without words. It can be music that you listen to or music that you play or sing yourself. You can find this music, stuff that you listen to on YouTube or on Spotify or SoundCloud. It could be music that you hear on TV or in movies. It can even be music from video games. So it could even be music that we've done in music class or in chorus or in band at school. But I want you to think about a song that sort of, inspires you, motivates you, makes you feel better. And I'd like you to share it with me in the comments of this assignment. So go to the assignment in your Google Classroom and leave a comment with your song. So I'll give you an example of mine. So one of the songs that I like to listen to when, you know, times like this, is the song I Can See Clearly Now. Now, this is an old song from like the 70s. I can see clearly now, the rain is gone. But the version that I like to listen to is actually a little more recent, and it's by a trumpet player and singer named Kermit Ruffins. Yes, his name really is Kermit. And he's got one of my favorite singing voices, and I love the way he plays trumpet. He sort of reminds me of Louis Armstrong. And what I wrote is, my motivating song is Kermit Ruffin's version of I Can See Clearly Now. The lyrics of this song talk about things will get better after the storm, and that even it is, and that even though it is raining now, reading is hard, the sunshine will return. I also like this song because it features a solo from Trombone Shorty, and it has an overall like a real funky groove to it. So that's the reason that I picked this song. So what I'd like you to do is think hard about that song, and you might know the title of it and the artist, or you might just know the title, or you might be, it's the song that says blah, 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 blah. And write out a couple of sentences about why that song is inspiring to you, is motivating to you, is helpful to you. And if you have a YouTube link, you can share that with us as well, too. Just make sure if, you know, we're sharing songs, that we're picking songs that are appropriate for school, and, you know, no objectionable lyrics in there. All right. So, that is your assignment for this week. Can you find a meaningful song to share with the rest of us? Now, let's turn it over to our musician of the month for the month of April, our last time visiting with The Roots. So, let's take a look at The Roots, and let's take a look at a couple of the members of The Roots. And so, I want to introduce you to the two founding members of the group. Over there on my far right is Questlove, and he's the drummer of The Roots. And then next to him is Black Thought, the main rapper and MC of The Roots. Now, those aren't their real names. Questlove's real name is Amir Thompson, and Black Thought's real name is Tariq Trotter. But those are their stage names that they use when they perform. Now, the reason I highlight these two gentlemen is because they're the founding members of the group. When they were in high school, they sort of got together to create The Roots. After school would get out, they would go hang out on the sidewalk. Questlove would get a bucket and some sticks and drum on the bucket, while Black Thought would do some rapping over Questlove's bucket drumming. And that's sort of how the group began. They didn't have any instruments or any electronics. They just kind of went out and played on the streets. Eventually, they added more musicians and created the group that we know and love today. I'd like to share with you a video today featuring Questlove drumming. Now, it's a little silly because it comes to us from Sesame Street, but this is a drum battle between Questlove and Grover. I hope you...
Hello there! M is for musician! A musician is a person who plays an instrument, like the drums here. To help me show you what a musician does, I have with me here my good friend, Mr. Questlove.
Hi.
A drummer is a musician. And luckily, we have one of the world's most amazing drummers right here.
Oh, man. Thank you, Grover.
Me!
You?
Correct. Now, are you ready to try and do what I do?
Sure.
That is the spirit. Okay, now, watch carefully. I call this the da-dum.
The da-dum.
Yes, here it comes.
Okay.
Okay. Did you get that? It is okay if you need me to do it again.
Hey, I think I got it. Yeah. Okay, this is the da-dum.
Yes, yes.
Okay.
Well, well, wow! You are a very quick learner, Mr. Questlove.
Yeah.
Are you ready for something really hard, though? I call this the deedle-deedle-dum. Hang on to your hi-hat, because... here it comes. It is perfectly okay if you want to give up now.
No.
No shame. No shame. Not from this direction.
I think I got it.
Yeah? Okay.
The deedle-deedle-dum.
Yes.
Okay.
Wow! You are one promising student.
Hey, thanks, Grover. Hey, Grover.
Hmm?
Can I try something for you? You
know. Well, if you want, I do not want you to embarrass yourself, but... Okay. Do not be afraid. Just try something.
Okay, this is called something. Here we go.
Hmm?
All right. That certainly was something. So that was our friend Questlove. Now, in the description of this video and in your Google Classroom, I'll have a link to another video featuring Black Thought. And this is Black Thought performing the song My Shot from Hamilton. He sort of did a reimagining of the song, and so you can hear him rapping his own version of My Shot to the musical Hamilton. The link to that will be in the description of this video, as well as in your Google Classroom. All right, so that's it for our April Musician of the Month, The Roots. Fifth grade, it's been a joy to be with you again. Thank you for participating in another digital music class with Mr. Houchin. I'll be back next Friday with another music class for you. But until then, goodbye. Goodbye, goodbye, fifth grade. Goodbye, goodbye, fifth grade. Goodbye, goodbye, fifth grade. Thank you for music. Goodbye, everybody, and have an